Travelers returning back to Metro Manila following the Holy Week break, around 126,000 passengers flocked to the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, or PTEX, on Easter Sunday. Authorities there are expecting the number of passengers to further go up today, Monday, to around 130 to 135,000, with a bulk coming in between 5 a.m. to 9. So we're about to see that now. Authorities note volumes this year are higher by around 20 to 30%. Meanwhile, bus terminals in Cubao, Quezon City are also filled with passengers returning from their provinces. Police and MMDA personnel were deployed along EDSA to ensure traffic management as well as the safety and security of the passengers. Some passengers in bus terminals in Manila, meanwhile, complained about the long travel time during the Holy Week. Some said their usual 14-hour travel was extended to 20 hours due to congestion. Tragedies mar the observance of the Holy Week here in the Philippines. Authorities recorded over a dozen deaths, 19 of which are drowning incidents, including an 8-year-old in Leyte. The Calabarzon region saw the highest number of fatalities, with 7 deaths reported. Meanwhile, separate vehicular accidents killed 2 people in Bulacan, while 2 more were injured in Region 5. The PNP also documented other incidents, including robbery, homicide, and fire in other parts of the country. Now, we have this just in. Police Major General Francisco Marbil has been designated as the next chief of the Philippine National Police, replacing Benjamin Acorda, whose term ended yesterday, Sunday. Marbil was former director of controllership and also previously headed the Highway Patrol Group, regional director of the Police Regional Office 8. Marbil is from the PMA's Sambisig class of 1991. He's scheduled to retire in February 2025. The United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization, or FAO, providing $1 million to boost the Philippine fisheries sector. The Agriculture Department says the funding will be spent on technical cooperation projects with a focus on the agri-fisheries sector. The grant is also about 40% higher than the $594,000 proposed by the DA. The agency adds the projects will provide additional support to regions affected by El Nino, helping communities recover and build resilience against future climate challenges. Turkey's main opposition party has declared victory in high-stakes elections, with Recep Tayyip Erdogan's AK party suffering a shocking defeat. With more than half of the votes already counted, Istanbul Mayor Ekrem İmamoğlu, led by nearly 10 percentage points in the mayoral race in Turkey's largest city, while his Republican People's Party retained Ankara and gained 9 other mayoral seats in big cities nationwide. Erdogan acknowledged defeat in an address to his supporters, pledging self-criticism.